What's happening, baby? We back to the PK show, man. Listen, this is a different segment right here, baby. This is when I sit down with my partners. My partners, man. You know what I mean? Ain't no faking. You know what I mean? Ain't no, hey, we done seen each other in the street or no, man. We partners, man. We 24 years.
Shit, man. This is 100.
Absolutely.
How you doing?
Come on,
bro?
Baby. How you doing? Listen, yeah, man. I got my
here,
partner.
This shit looking dope.
You like that?
Yeah, the whole setup, dope.
Yeah, we gotta hurry up, cause we gotta go back.
Nice and classy, man. It's a cool ass chair.
This guy got it from our rent. What is that? Rental center.
Rental center.
Green Rock.
Oh, hell yeah. Yeah, they come back and get their shit.
Look here, man. We in here with that boy DJ Toomp tonight, baby. Y'all don't know him like I know him, but we going to get to it, man. We going to teach y'all something tonight. What you been up to, man?
Man, shit. You know, still creating music, trying to manage a few producers and situations, but mostly real estate, bro.
Really?
You know, the music industry will send you to another hustle in a minute, bro.
You better have another.
All this streaming shit, man. You know, I'm used to counting CDs and sales.
Man, you know, man, I'm so glad you said that. So I'm having a conversation with a dude the other day.
Mm-hmm.
And we talking about Adele, what she did to sell all the records. Like, she wouldn't even stream.
Right.
You had to buy the album.
Yeah. Physical.
Yeah. I'm going to tell you, man, this is my only issue. Why is it only black music is saying records ain't selling no more?
Man, really because you got a new generation who don't even understand sales. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
It's very rare that you'll hear that from somebody in, you know, from 45 to 50. It's the new generation because they really ain't selling. Mm. You know what I mean? It's streaming. Mm. So, you know, we come from that physical aspect of selling records, man. You know, lines wrapped around super sounds and shit.
Mm-hmm.
Same shit, line about the same length as the motherfucker who want to get some Jordans. Because
mm-hmm.
it's physical. You know what I mean? When you're selling something physical, like tickets, you know what I mean? You got to be there to get that. But now that, shit, let's say if you want a new Drake album, I can just blow it through a straw. It's in your phone.
Right.
You know what I mean? You ain't paid shit for it.
Right.
And,
right.
So it's really like, ain't nobody really selling too tough, but I mean, the show game is really where it is.
But Drake actually sold some records, right?
I mean, he sold records.
Yeah.
But when you look at it though, you gotta think. And we just had a debate too. I was asking, in 2019, 2018, we consider selling records if, what, somebody sold 1.8?
I guess.
Well, come on, that was scratching the surface.
Right, absolutely.
When you speak of what, 2003
absolutely.
And down,
right.
Shit, motherfuckers were going 3-4 million. Mm-hmm. Nelly sold 10 million twice.
Absolutely.
Man went, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So it's like kind of like, all right, if it was still physical copies being sold, how much you think Drake would have really sold? Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Would it have made it to the 10 million mark? That's what I'm saying. It's like a lot of these cats really are not getting
up.
Yeah, they ain't really getting a real chance to see what the hell they got nowadays. You know what I mean?
That's good.
Because you got to think, because they really don't even care. Once you just say, all right, such a stream that 300,000 first week, had this other guy stream that, what, 40,000. But guess what? He getting 50,000 a night hitting the stage. We talking about 4 shows a week.
Mm-hmm.
Shit, bro, that's dope boy money.
Yeah. It's funny, man, because I feel like the internet has gotten the star and the popular person confused.
Mm.
You know what I mean?
I agree.
I think there's a difference between being popular and being a star.
Mm-hmm.
And it's confusing when you put them in the same arena or the same area.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
I've seen it happen.
And it's funny because I talk to a lot of dudes and they're like, man, you crazy, he's a star. I'm like, boy. He is not a star. And you're not going to see that until a star walk in the room. And I believe the popular people, that's why they hide behind the internet, because if you put them in the most of these dudes now, if you put them in the room, I'll tell you, I probably couldn't tell you.
Oh, man, there's some little weirdos, man.
You see what I'm saying?
I mean, ain't nobody specific. Ain't like
yeah,
a call
yeah,
man, a lot of niggas some little weirdos, man.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah,
so
you
it's
can
just
drop
like,
them in the middle of some real shit.
Right.
Yeah, they wouldn't know what to do.
Yeah, so it's funny when I tell people, I'm like, listen, man, it's been the same stars for the last 10 years.
Mm.
like, you done got
some. Got me thinking now.
You done got some popular people.
Yeah.
But the stars are the stars. So, yeah,
that's true.
And what I tell people all the time, I'm like, you can be successful.
Mm-hmm.
That's not like. This
that don't mean
that,
you're a star.
That don't mean you're a star.
Right.
You know what I mean?
That's true.
And yeah. It's like, so you want to have this argument, like, this guy is this and this. No, he has a place.
You're right.
In here, which is cool. And that's his space.
And that's real shit, because you think about it, out of all the R&B shit, just think, you know, we were growing up. Freddie Jackson had a gang of records, but he wasn't a star.
Listen, man, I tell people that all the time.
Yeah, Freddie Jackson wasn't a star, but he got a gang of hits,
listen,
you know what
man,
I mean?
I told 3,000, I said, boy, listen, stop taking pictures with folk.
Yeah. Keep that mystique.
Like,
keep that mystique.
Man, what I say, they ain't earned that.
Yeah.
They not even supposed to be in the room with you.
Yeah, for
and,
real.
And people don't understand there's levels to this.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And it's what it is. It's just life. Yeah. So just like you said, Gerald LaVert was a hell of a singer.
Mm-hmm.
I love Gerald LaVert.
Mm-hmm.
But he wasn't supposed to be in the room with Michael Jackson.
You don't think so?
Hell no. So when Mike say, hey man, look, I fought with Gerald. But yeah, tell
him. I got to clear this bitch out.
Yeah, tell him stay over there, man. Ain't nothing wrong with that.
No, that's real.
That's real.
No, that's real.
So I'm not telling you ain't the shit. I'm telling you, boy, I'm here.
That's kind of what why I would say Beyonce is still a superstar.
Because
you never seen her on no Breakfast Club, none of that old shit. You know what I mean? She stay away. She keep that mystique.
Yeah.
You know? She ain't really just putting herself out there too much. You know
yeah,
what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think not. But
that, and even
right?
that, she only come out.
But that's why 3,000 still a star, though.
And now we're going to get to that.
But oh, shit.
We're going to get to that. But Beyonce is, she only come out to have to kick ass.
Yeah.
That's
hard.
It.
That's hard. I like the way you put that.
She only come out to, who? Y'all say who the shit?
Yeah.
Where that
she show
at?
Up every time.
Where she at?
Yeah.
She going to be where tonight?
Put a fucking album together
in 2 weeks.
Hey,
man, get the babysitter. Call the babysitter. I got to get
I'm
out.
I'm going tonight. In. I'm going in.
That's what stars are.
Oh, shit. Yeah.
Stars want to, they want that. They want that.
Man.
Oh, you supposed to be? Stars don't, hey, you want to get on my album? Hey, let's do a song. See, this one don't nobody remember.
Mm-hmm.
This one I knew Beyonce was absolutely the shit.
Okay.
1 year, she did an album with everybody who was supposed to be the shit.
Mm.
And this one I knew she was a fool. I said, oh, boy, she bought that shit. She did a song with Shakira. You remember that?
Uh-uh.
Everybody was going crazy about Shakira that year.
Right.
Shaking her ass, doing a little dance.
Okay, I do remember that time, yeah.
Beyonce did a song with her and shot the video just to show y'all. This who y'all fucking with?
Y'all like? Yeah.
Watch this.
Yeah.
And it killed the video. She competition, baby.
That's
she
dope.
Competitor.
That's dope. But yeah, man, it's like, there's only a few superstars left, man. And I don't know. What you think right now?
So here's what I think.
Yeah, what you think would in 2019, what you think would make a motherfucker star? Like you say, no matter how many streams they've gotten or
so here's
how much
my thing.
Trouble they done got into or some bullshit.
So we both know a star is just who you are.
Okay.
And ain't got nothing to do with what you do.
Mm-hmm.
You can strip everything from that person.
Mm-hmm.
And he gonna be a star if he work at Waffle House.
Mm-hmm.
If he at Foot Locker working, he gonna be a star.
Yeah, everybody gonna be talking about that dude up
that's
at Foot Locker.
That's all
yeah,
I'm
that particular branch.
That's,
yeah.
You can't teach people that. You can't do that.
Real shit.
So, but here's the trick. It's two ways you can sell artists. And this when I talk to people, they most people don't get anything on crazy. But there's two ways you can sell an artist, right?
Mm-hmm.
You can sell a star.
Mm-hmm.
Now they look identical.
Right.
You can sell a star, or you can sell exceptional talent.
Mm.
You see what I'm saying?
Okay, yeah, one of the two.
Yeah, one of the two.
It's a blessing to have both, though.
Boy, if you got both, you got it.
You're a motherfucker. You got at least 12 years.
You got two, then you got you, Michael Jackson.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But, so what happens is, you sell this exceptional talent.
Right.
It goes and goes and go as long as it's doing
right
what you're selling.
Mm.
As soon as it stops doing what you were selling,
mm-hmm. It just fade out.
It's a different ball
like
game.
Fucking haircut. Yeah, quick.
You know what I mean? It's a different ball game.
Who you think? You think at one point everybody was like, yo, Chris Brown could be our Michael. You think at one point he could have, before he really got to the trouble, that he could have been that guy?
Here's the thing about being a star.
If not him, who?
I'm going to tell you. Here's the thing about being a star, and this is the only reason Michael Jackson and Prince were able to capture what they did. In order to be a superstar, mm-hmm. you have to completely disconnect from the world.
From the world. Man, you couldn't have said it no better. That's real.
Michael Jackson had giraffes and shit walking around the house.
Yeah. He made this, well, he ain't had to even leave the fucking house. And
motherfucker was out of his mind.
Yeah.
To crazy. Be great at something,
right?
You gotta be fucked up and everything else. Mm. It don't happen. You can't be great. Mm-hmm. You can't even be good and everything.
Yeah.
Like, it don't happen. That's not real.
Yeah, you're gonna fall short on something.
And you have to accept that.
If not, nigga, you from Mars.
Hey man, you feel what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it's like the problem is trying to be normal and be a star at the same time.
Yeah, that don't work.
It's not happening. Trying to be liked and be a star at the same time, it doesn't mm-hmm. happen. So the issue is, and it's even with our kids, nobody's telling you to. Hey man, you better get out there and step on their neck.
Right.
Fuck them folk.
Yeah.
I love you.
Yeah.
I'm worried about it. Listen.
Yeah.
Everybody in this house love you.
Right.
When you walk out this door, fuck every one of them motherfuckers.
Bust their fucking heads. That's real.
They not saying that. So cause guess what?
Yeah, now, I be helping my little daughter up like that sometimes.
Come on.
I ain't gonna lie.
So now you're dealing with
text her with that shit in the morning. Yeah.
You know why it ain't no fucking stars? Cause now you're dealing with the generation of in young little league sports, you pay to play. Mm. If my daddy bought the uniforms, I get to play.
So my mama cook all the fish on
come
Saturday.
Come on, I get to play.
God damn it, yeah.
Turn the scoreboard off if we getting blown out. Nigga, champs come from losing.
Yeah.
Champs don't come from winning.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
That's it. Yeah.
So now you're dealing with a bunch of entitled kids that's running around here thinking that somebody owe them something, and they supposed to be in the room with the 3,000. How?
Yeah.
You ain't sold, nigga. You ain't did nothing.
He ain't put in no work.
And you ain't did nothing.
He's got to take a loss somewhere.
Come on, man.
Some type of humbling situation, experience need to be in that journey.
Listen, man.
Yeah.
When you get out there and somebody kicking
make you want to do better. Yeah.
You get out there and somebody kicking your ass, two things gonna happen. You gonna go get your shit together and come back and kick some ass.
Right.
Or you gonna get the hell on and never come back.
Right.
Right.
Yeah, one of the two.
That's it. So if you're not putting a kid or putting somebody up against something,
mm-hmm.
you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
What the hell are you developing?
Yeah.
You developing a child who ain't gonna never know how to fight.
Yeah, and when you get into the real world, he or she, yeah, they gonna be fucked.
So now you got a million niggas just like that,
mm.
that's supporting him, and like, yeah, he the shit. Yeah, he.
So that's where they done set the bar.
Come on.
Setting them off right
that's
on the fuck shit. Like, for real.
That's all I'm saying.
Got your kid thinking like this right here is supreme level.
That's all I'm saying.
Well, we come from this shit, but now, yeah, they got it down here to where, oh shit, okay. All you got to do is just say a few words.
That's all I'm saying.
Throw some goddamn diamonds on.
That's all
you that nigga.
That's all I'm saying.
Yeah.
So now you go on the white side of things and look at who's moving numbers.
Right.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
And you like, look at what they're actually doing and the time they're taking and moving, and then they're still, white music is still handling everything about it the same as they did years and years
country
ago.
Country music, man.
Right?
Yeah, come on, man. I love just looking at billboards just to watch the
Give me one white album. Artist. Give me one of them white artists that say, we got to drop an album every 6 months.
We need to put out
a mixtape.
Need to get our buzz going.
Come on,
I need this many YouTube hits.
So I believe that we always had it fucked up. The biggest trick they ever played on us was they told us money was power.
Yeah.
Power, like money is not power.
Nah.
Power is influence.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So they give you money for your power.
Gang of it, yeah.
They're buying the power from you, which is your influence.
Right.
Right? But now, if I can get you popular, mm-hmm. and get you okay with being popular.
Mm-hmm.
And now when you come back to renegotiate, guess what I say? Man, you ain't sold shit.
You ain't sold shit, yeah.
What I gotta give you?
Yeah.
But them 200, 300, 400, 500,000 followers you got, I need that.
Yeah, oh, you need.
Yeah, I need that. Yeah, I need access.
360 shit popping off.
Talk to me, baby. No, I need access to that.
You know what I'm gonna tell you? I think B2K started that 360 shit.
Really?
Like, as far as not the group, but the label that they were under. Mm-hmm. Because you got to think, around that time, that's when them dudes were having, what, the Scream Tour or whatnot. Mm-hmm. And that group, it did pretty good, but they weren't really selling that many units. Mm-hmm. But they were grossing like 20 and 30 mil off their tours. Mm-hmm. And that's when the label started getting curious, like hey, man, money. Hold on. Yeah, God damn, right. Man, we spent $2 million on promoting this album, and it barely went gold. But y'all come back off tour, and y'all 30 mil? Ooh. We got to eat that.
Right.
We got to get some of that.
Right.
And that's when motherfuckers, you know, things like Luke, Baby, and now, you know, independent labels been doing 360. They just didn't call it that.
Right, absolutely.
You know, but Cash Money was on the road, shit, Baby was out there with him. Yeah. Two Live Crew was on the road. Yeah. Luke was out there with him.
Absolutely.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Right. Right. Like, who from a label finna come out and kick it on the road with T.I. or anybody else?
You're right.
You know what I mean? So that's why they had to come up with that situation that'll be like, all right, we putting this money into you, but if you don't sell this many records, but you're making way more than us, mm-hmm. Oh no, we got to get that.
Don't make sense.
Yeah.
So it's funny because I told somebody, I said, man, let me tell you something. They're not trying to make any more Rockefellers, mm-mm. Bad Boys, all that. Mm-mm. And the thing is, these artists now work for that. Mm. They work for that.
Right.
They can't come to Toomp and say, hey man, listen, I'm gonna give you this chunk boy situation. But I'm gonna have you the hottest thing in the city.
Right.
You're like, boy, you out your mind? Where the money at?
Yeah, where that
where the split?
At? Yeah,
where the numbers real. At?
Yeah.
So now you get a bunch of kids that don't care. They wanna be popular. They already giving it away. Like one time I walk up and man, I pulled up at a studio and you know me. It was a perfect situation. As soon as I pull up, I see a white guy.
All the right people were there, huh?
Oh my God.
I know you can just let loose on
that. I see a white guy and a bunch of rappers, a bunch of folk around. Mm-hmm. I'm like, this looks interesting. I get out of the car.
Who was it, man? Who was it?
I
know.
I walk up, I say, hey, what is it? Oh man, it's such, man. He owned he got a mixtape site. I said, oh, this who that is.
Okay.
I said, y'all, let me explain something to y'all. I say, so y'all spend all y'all time and hard work putting together this music to give it him, to him to give away for free.
Give it for free.
I say, so y'all get on his site, give all y'all music away for free. I say, but guess what? He's getting paid off advertising.
He put some fucking tag on it. Right. Yeah, you're fucking right.
No. I said, no, hold on, man. Hold on. I say, so he's getting paid for y'all to give y'all music away for free. Does that even make sense?
Bruh.
Y'all empowering him.
It's that new generation.
Because man. Y'all giving away the music for free because you just want to be popular.
Guess what? And how many out of that bunch of people, how many you think really listened to what you said, though?
Probably none of them.
Nah, them niggas don't listen, bro.
That old head shit.
Yeah. Niggas don't want to hear that. They don't want to hear that, man. And see, the thing about it, dog, was really killing the industry. And people heard me, I've said it before. There's only a few people real enough to say this shit, is that right now, the music industry is the only, let's make this shit clear, the only industry that you can get into without a certification, without being educated on anything. Listen, man, if you want to open a barbershop, you got to learn about all that shit, pass the state board,
absolutely.
Your sink's got to be a certain way.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. If you want to open a wing stand,
it's cold.
You got to pass inspection.
But
a motherfucker who got 300, you know, from hustling money, you know, okay, sitting under his mom's house or wherever he got his money at, wake up and just stretch and be like, shit, man, I'm going to start this label, going and put some money behind these little younger. He's the CEO now.
That's it.
And don't know nothing about publishing. Don't know anything about licensing, don't even know music, period. Mm-hmm. Like, this is the only business that you could do that. And that's why you got so many criminals in this shit right now.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
Like, and not, you know, a lot of these dudes are really from the streets to this industry.
Mm-hmm.
No filter, no type of development. It's bad, bro.
So one of the major things, I think, one of the biggest reasons I honestly believe the DJ is the cause for what the climate is now.
The DJ.
And I'm gonna tell you why. Cause there used to be a time where everybody listened to the DJ.
Mm-hmm.
And we depended on the DJ.
Yeah.
If the DJ said, this is it, boy, that's
what
we riding with.
We rocking with
right?
it, yeah.
So now when you were able to pay the DJ.
Oh, yeah.
So now the DJ turned it into a hustle. Real.
Yeah, it's a hustle now.
It's like, so you telling me all that is it? So anybody got $1,500 is it?
Yeah.
It don't make sense no more.
Yeah.
How bad music got to be for niggas to stop taking free CDs?
Yeah.
No, cause I'm good. I'm good.
I'm good. I'm just making me some jam shit.
You see what I'm saying? You don't put. Shit. You done flooded the block with so much bullshit.
Yeah.
Because of the money.
Right.
That I don't even got time. Like, don't even try to. I don't even want to figure it out.
Yeah.
No more.
Folks don't even want to even take time to listen. Give it a fair listen.
Come
somebody
on, man.
Brand new. Yeah, it used to be a thing to break a new artist.
That's
man.
All I'm saying.
That was a pride of a DJ to be able to say, I broke this artist. Mm-hmm. I broke this new T.I., I broke this new such and such, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But now, yeah, nobody get no excitement from that shit.
That's what I'm saying. So now you playing these records that I know for a fact.
Right.
Ain't
right.
it.
Ain't it.
But all of them had $1,000. But the one motherfucker who the shit, he can't get in there because he ain't got $1,000.
Hard time. Yeah. It might take him about 5 years to get there.
And see what I try to explain.
Hopefully they ain't too old.
Hey, man, come on. And what I try to explain to people, I'm like, you think somebody be like somebody's bitching about these bad artists,
mm-hmm.
but they clogging up space.
Yeah.
And when a group is successful, when somebody's the shit, it creates money for people that ain't even got nothing to do with you.
Right.
Money starts popping up around the city again.
Right.
And people start writing a check again because they believe in, boy, Atlanta got it.
Yeah.
They shut down on Atlanta after Trinidad James.
You think so?
They went, the labels.
Right.
They were like, hell no.
Yeah, yeah, that shit came and went.
They
so
got
fast.
Tired Gee of being whiz. Tricked.
Yeah, it was a trick.
And it just wasn't him, it was a bunch
it
of
was
them.
It was a few of them, yeah, a whole gang of them.
So
yeah.
Now the problem is, you got these squares working at the label, right? They go hire these squares, because guess what? The squares ain't trying to be Murder, Inc.
Right.
The squares ain't trying to be Rockefeller.
Yeah.
The squares ain't trying to do all that. They just trying to be cool.
They just want that bag and to be a part of the culture. They figure
because they squares, right? They lanes anyway.
Yeah.
So think about this. If you come into my business.
My kids say they lanes anyway.
Think about it too.
Nah, a lot of niggas, I got to get to
if you. If I bring you into my business.
Right.
You come in with all these big, bright ideas.
Right.
And you get in, you go, now I done broke you off.
Right.
You go get this house. You go get this car. You finally around the cool niggas.
Right.
And I threaten you with sending you back to the squares.
Right.
You gonna do what the hell I tell you to do.
Oh, you gonna do everything. Yeah. Yeah. Everything's required.
So that's if I real. Tell you we need a bunch of that, hey man, we don't need that. You better go get us
get
that.
He gonna go get that.
That's what he gonna do.
Yeah, that's some of that young and dumb.
Yeah. So think about it. We the only people that don't control our culture.
Mm.
You go into a room and it's a 60-year-old white boy telling you what hot on Bankhead. That shit don't even make sense.
Damn.
Like, how a 60-year-old white boy about to tell you what's
hot
on Bankhead?
Tell you what the hell happening in the SWAT, for real. And yeah.
So yeah, man, so you been here for a minute, man. You been doing your thing.
Yes, sir.
So let me ask you something, man, and everybody wanna know. Like, that T.I. and that Toomp chemistry, man, it's just like, it's so needed. You know what I mean?
I
would love to see it. I mean, you know what I mean? I don't understand. I don't know.
What you mean you don't know?
I just don't.
Oh, you trying to figure out why
same? Yeah. How can we?
I ain't gonna lie. I'm like, I could be on some lightweight Dr. Dre type shit. I'd be wanting to perfect that shit. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Like, I'm not used to just giving nobody beats and they go in there, next thing you know, it's out. I like to really, truly produce an artist, dog. You know what I mean? Like, after they rap over the track, boom. All right. You know this track might not sound the way that it did when you just rapped on it, because mm-hmm. I'm going to take it and really put the shit to it.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how all the classics that you done heard from us is, I actually went back and put certain shit to it. He didn't just take that two track and the files and just put that out. So when it got to the point, I would say around like 07, 08, that's when it was like, yo, just give us the files. And I wasn't able to really just do too much to it.
Okay.
And so that take a whole lot away from it. You know what I mean? Even right nowadays, where we are, and it's a thing when you really vibing with an artist physically.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? It's like now, you can listen to a song now and could tell if those two artists were there at the same time, or they might have sent the files to the West Coast.
Yeah, I got you.
When people used to get on each other and collab on songs, like when you hear Niggas in Paris, you could tell Jay-Z and Kanye is there because they're going back and forth.
We got you.
You know what I mean? They sharing a verse and they doing that. So nowadays, what we are is just so microwave to the point to where, okay, yeah, I got this song. I want Rick Ross on it. Oh yeah, he's in Germany. Send the files to him. And once he hear what the song is about, he might rap about it, you know, put his verse on, but that shit ain't organic. You see what I'm saying?
So are you saying don't nobody want to be produced no more?
Nobody want to be produced. They just want beats and run in their own little corner. You know, me and Tip do something, man. I, you know, everybody was like, oh, Tip and Toomp album, but it might have to end up being a Toomp and Tip album. Some shit that I do and just put him on my album more than anything. That's if I decide to do that, man. Mm-hmm. I keep running around throwing these verticals up, bro. I might not even.
But that's a cool thing. I think a lot of time we get caught up in that big brother, little brother type of thing.
It happens.
You know what I mean?
Oh yeah, yeah.
I got a couple of situations like that, and it's like, you know, it's just,
yeah,
it's hard to get that.
That's real.
You know what I mean? That thing back. You
yeah.
Know what I mean? It's like big brother done grew. I mean, little brother done grew up.
Yeah.
And it's like, hey man, what the hell you gonna
say? That's crazy. And it was wild because somebody compared that when I did the Kanye Big Brother song. Mm-hmm. It was like, oh man, this song almost reminded me of you and Tip. Yeah. I'm like, damn, that is kind of deep. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I got so many. I mean, and what a lot of people don't understand is, regardless if we do business together, there's still a friendship on the backside of that.
That's the beauty.
That nobody really gets to see. Of course, the music game ain't what it used to be.
I won't, you know what? I won't even just say, you know, it definitely ain't gonna be, ain't nothing gonna be the way it used
absolutely
to be. You know what I mean? Everything's gonna evolve and change to some type of degree. But, and it's always not gonna be in our favor.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? But you know me, man, come on, I've been doing this since 85. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Come on, man, I had records in rotation in high school.
I just saw Shadi.
Telling my homeroom teacher, that's my shit you heard on the radio.
I just saw Shadi at Dugan's.
Yeah, I'm about to say, boy, it's so much we can cover, man. Shit,
oh, man.
And the world just don't know.
Oh, man. Come on, man. It's funny, man, because I tell people all the time, I'm like, listen, man, the dudes in Atlanta, they mess with each other and been messing with each other. I mean, it just, it ain't even got nothing to do with music.
Right.
It just is what it is.
Right.
You know what I mean? And
yeah.
Atlanta just always been a cool place like that for dudes that's from Atlanta.
Yeah.
And been,
yeah.
You know what I mean? So
yeah,
to get a chance to see it go from something so small to something so big,
mm-hmm,
you know, it was a cool thing. And to actually have a part in that and be around that,
yeah,
you know what I mean? I'm always blessed for that. Music really doesn't do it for me anymore.
Yeah, and that's why every time they have me on panels and whatnot, you know, A3C and all these different conferences and whatnot, sometime when I'm at AIU, at all the little music schools and whatnot, I talk about music, but I just be like, get on some man shit. Let's talk about just being a man.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like, music shit, all right, that's cool, but now let's talk about this, you know?
Absolutely.
How you don't sit there and just sweat nobody for an hour. No, walk up to that man and introduce yourself. Don't just look at nobody. Like, that's, nigga might take that the wrong way.
Right.
Either you funny or you got them up to something. You know what I mean? Like, just man shit.
Yeah,
you
absolutely.
Know?
Absolutely. Well, I tell you what,
so
man.
A lot of these cats need to learn that, man. That's
absolutely
why I try to push more than
with
just
you,
music shit. You know,
well, we got to come back to get you back on the PK show, man.
Yeah,
so
let's
we can
do it.
This conversation.
Yeah, man, this shit is
talk
dope.
I
love what you're doing,
you
man.
Like it, man.
And, shit, I will be back. All you got to do is let me know.
Yeah,
I show
man,
up.
I figured I'd take all this old good looking shit to the big screen. You know what I mean?
Well,
man, look up, man. This is my partner, DJ Toomp, baby. Look, let me tell you something. You're looking at two of the best smiles in the city, baby. You know what I mean?
Like, he's real, baby.
Holler at us, man. It's PK, man. Come back and check us out, man.